I'm working on my own animated series, as I talked about in my last video, and I'm in the character design stage right now, among other things. And one of the things that came out of that work is this puppet, Hugo. And today I wanted to look a little bit more into what this puppet can do and how you can use it for yourself. So here in Character Animator, we first want to load up the puppet. So now it's important, as always, you click the puppet so it's activated and you click this little clapperboard to add it to a new scene. So it will create a new scene with the puppet inside for you. So let's check our scene properties by clicking the scene up here. It should be set to 12 and it should be 4K. So the first thing I want to do here is click the puppet. We should have activated the triggers behavior down here. The special thing about this puppet is that you can, inside of here, inside of the scene with the triggers activated, you can use a bunch of keyboard triggers to change the appearance. Starting with the number row at the top of the keyboard, you can change the hair color and all the hair will change. And then you go down to the next row, which starts with a Q. You can change the skin color. And if you want to get rid of the spots, you can do that. I like this one. If you're wondering what keys you have available or what you can change, under triggers here you can see all the keys. So what did we do? We did the spots, we did the skin shade, we did the hair color, and now we can see, okay, next thing is hairstyle. So that's those three keys, ASD. I think I'm gonna leave it like this. I really like this one. Next thing is H, G, and F, so you can change the nose. Oh, this one looks nice. I will leave it like this. With L, K, and J, you change the style of the beard. So you can have this one or this one. I really like this one. And then you have a chin style, which also has a beard in it. Let's see if I press X, it will give him this kind of beard. I kind of like this whole appearance now. These two gestures, we're going to leave them alone for now. The one remaining thing you can change is the shirt color, and that's going to be done with U, I, and O. You shouldn't press play now or use the playhead in any way, because this will reset the puppet to its default state and you will have to make all these inputs again. The next thing, after you decided how your puppet's supposed to look, you go up to timeline, record one frame take, and this will give you a one frame recording of every single trigger you changed. You can now select all of these and drag them out as far as you want them. And now if you move the playhead, your puppet will look like you want it to look. Being done with the appearance, we deactivate the triggers behavior. And now it's time to record the movement. Turn on the camera and the microphone. And now you can see it's recognizing my voice. It's recognizing my movement. Calibrate it real quick. Press record. And now let's just record real quick a little piece. There you go. Stop it again. So we can turn off the camera again, the microphone. We can turn off all of these things now. We don't need them anymore because we recorded them. And now go back to the triggers and record some more triggers. And that's the ones we left out in the beginning, N and M. And I activated the triggers now. And if I press N or M, it will do some kind of hand gesture. Let's press record one more time. Now let's just record real quick a little piece. There you go. All right, so now let's just record real quick a little piece. There you go.
Pretty straightforward, it's really easy to use. If I did the math correctly, he should have over 10,000 different combinations. So if you want to use him, like download him and also get a 25% discount, you should definitely check out the link in the description. Let me know what you think in the comments, and what I would really appreciate and like is if you would share anything you create with him on my new Discord channel, which you would also find down in the description. That's it, see you next time.